Hello, everybody. My name is Star, and welcome back to the Time Shot Server. Now, last time you guys saw the Nether Hub, either on stream or on camera on here, I was, you know, working on all the glass, the segments, and things like that. Things have progressed quite a bit since we last saw the hub. Loads of people have been working on it. Dave's been doing an absolute ton of digging. He actually just logged off, but he's been doing a ton of digging. Edson's been doing a lot of work too. He's been getting everyone's tunnels to connect to the new hub, and he got rid of the old box that the hub used to be in, and all that's left of it now is this portal sitting right here. I filled out all the glass. I've got the quartz all laid out on the border and things like that. There are blazes spawning little tiny bit. Ooh, a little tiny bit unfortunate. I don't know if blazes are affected by light or not. We might have to do a couple tests on that. But unfortunately, as you could see by the nether brick there, we kind of spawned right next to a, I say spawned, the whole hub is right next to a fortress, which isn't ideal, but you know, it's fine. It's totally fine. I'm gonna get this quartz actually, because I do need a bit more quartz. Let me show you guys exactly. Well, I want to show you. I could go into my creative world, but I'm lazy, so I'm not gonna do that. but today we're gonna be working on a couple of things. All of these slabs here, by the way, to stop ghasts from spawning, and I think it's worked so far because we haven't had any ghast spawning in here, except for very occasionally in the segments themselves. Now today we're going to be doing this portal dibbly dabbly do up here. We're going to be making into the proper sundial spike, and we're also going to be doing the forest biome in one of these slices. It doesn't really matter which slice, you know, they're going to kind of be random, but my aim is to work on one or two slices per episode. I might get people into collab as well, maybe do like a little, oh, there's Tort. Bye Tort. Hi, bye, see you later, Tort. I might be bringing people in to do like little chatty episodes with, and we can work on designing them together. But it's time to start fleshing out the floor before we really get into any of the walls or things like that. This is also being dug out as well, but the floor doesn't need any kind of any kind of height to it. So we're gonna be working on that. Now the first thing we're gonna do is this portal here, which I think we can just about manage to do without moving that portal, so people can still get to it if they want to, at least for the first bit. I have a chest chock full of things that I need. I've got a lot of quartz here to decorate it with. I'm actually going to use obsidian first though, of course, because you need the obsidian to make the portal. The portal is going to be quite big. It's going to be kind of like that sort of dibbly dabbly do. You know, I kind of set out to finish this before the world downloaded at the end of March, and I was like, there's no way this hub is going to be finished by the end of March. Even though in my mind, I was like, it'd be really nice if it was. I was like, there's no way it's going to be done by then. But actually, everyone has pulled together to get this whole thing hollowed out. Like, I don't know if it's going to be any taller than this. It'll probably end up being a little bit taller than this, maybe. If it's possible for it to get much taller. I don't really know how tall it could be. It looks like it could be a few layers taller. But I didn't think it would be possible to get this all. Like, look how dug out this is. This is nuts. If you remember how small it was before, like, it's absolutely crazy. And this is all done over the course of a couple of days. You know, the floor's going to come along nicely. Hopefully I'll get a couple of episodes of this recorded quite soon. And then, you know, the walls can be started on. And oh, I'm so excited, guys. I'm so excited. Now, building the sundial is going to take a little bit of work and a little bit of counting blocks. So I'm going to cut back in when I've started on at least the base for the portal. So we've got the base for the portal here. Now, the portal is quite a lot bigger. And how this design works is it's going to be like a dial that you would see on a sundial. So it's going to kind of curve up like this, and then it's going to have a bit that points out, and then it's going to go back in kind of like that. And the portal is going to be the middle bit in it. So when you hop out kind of onto the sundial, and then you can just choose to walk to whichever portal is yours. Now I'm gonna build it all out of quartz for now. I don't know if the actual material this is gonna be made of is going to change at all, but the basic idea is gonna be quartz for now. Now it's kind of built in such a way that it kind of staggers up a little bit like staircases. So we've got one here, and then we've got two here, and then we've got two on top of that, and then we got, oops, two on top of that. And then it starts to get a little bit tricky. I don't want to make this portal completely inaccessible, but very soon it's going to be a little bit tricky to build any more on this. I might have to demolish this portal sooner than I thought, because this is going to collide with it very, very quickly. Also, I think I may have messed up my measurements a bit. Not entirely sure. I might have messed up my measurements. I'm going to cut back in once I have a little bit of a better idea. I'm working off my creative world at the moment, so I've got Minecraft open in a separate window, and I'm kind of looking at that and working it out, and then I'm, you know, going back over here and working that out. So bear with me just a second. I'm an idiot, and it is perfectly fine. I didn't mess up my measurements. I messed up thinking that I messed up my measurements, but it's perfectly fine. I think it's time to destroy this portal. I'm hoping this one will work. I hope it connects up okay. Let me break this portal. We're gonna need all the obsidian from this one anyway. Because I don't think I have enough obsidian. Let's go through. Fingers crossed it comes out in the right place. Please, 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 please. Okay, well that comes out here. So that's all good. Okay, let's go here and go through. Fingers crossed we come out of the big portal. Is that, yeah, it's worked. Hey, there we go. Okay, awesome. All right, so we can demolish this portal, and now we've got our brand new portal for people to use instead. Fantastic. Okay, I didn't do my measurements wrong. It actually took me a little while to work out how to make the chiseled quartz. I love quartz blocks. They're one of my favorite blocks in Minecraft, but I don't use them that much in builds, mainly because they're quite expensive, because it's quite difficult to get a hold of quartz. I say, as I see quartz in the ceiling there, but generally speaking, especially with Poet on the server building his whole base out of quartz, it's a little bit tricky to get a hold of quartz sometimes, and kind of dangerous as well. There we go. Is that all of that portal? That is. I should have enough obsidian. Actually, I don't need any more to finish this portal. It's nice to have a little bit extra, though. That ghast isn't anywhere here, is it? No. Good. I'm still paranoid ghasts are going to start spawning. All right, let's get rid of this platform. So, the tricky part of this portal is, obviously, I want it to be... Let's get rid of all this. I want it to be level with the ground, because I did not mean to mine you. I am sorry. There we go. I want it to be level with the ground, because I don't want people to have to, like, you know, jump up to get into the portal. But then we've got this old ugly little stripe here, which is kind of the tricky thing. Now, in my creative world, what I did was, let me get my silk touch pick out. I broke all the glass, like so, and I just put is it quartz or is it bone blocks? I think it's quartz. Do I have any regular quartz blocks on me? Oh, they'll be in here, won't they? They'll be in this chest here. There we go. I just laid down regular quartz for now, but I don't know if I like that. I mean, I could take out more of this and do it so it's like that, so it surrounds the whole portal like this, but I don't know if I like that or not. But then I can't really see any other way of hiding the ugly, ugly obsidian, because this is all going to be covered up. I'm doing it so there's going to be quartz blocks on the side, so the obsidian's mostly going to be covered up. You can't see very much of it. So I don't know. Oops. I don't know if I want this quartz to be on the bottom, or if it's better to have a portal where, you know, it starts yay high instead. But then people would have to, like, you know, jump up to get into the portal, and, you know, when you jump down, oops, oh well, that's gone into the other side now. And then, I don't know. I don't know if I like that idea or not. I might have to go to the other side and collect my quartz back. So I might have to play around with the height a little bit. I think I do want it to stay on a level that's, the same level as the actual sundial itself, because I do want the sundial surface to be quite flat. So I might just have to keep it with the quartz down here like this, or even, you know, it might just be a case of, okay, you're still seeing that. Let's fill this in here. This is a little bit of death down there, just tiny bit of death. Might actually prefer to just keep it with you seeing the obsidian and being like, tough. If you see it, it's too bad. It's your own problem to deal with. I'm not entirely sure. Yeah, if people have suggestions, that'd be great. Because this isn't, you know, this isn't by any means going to be the final design, what this this portal ends up being like. Let's, there we go, pearl up here. So you could just see the obsidian. That's just, you know, that's just what it is. I don't entirely know yet. Maybe I'll have the quartz spreading all the way across the whole segment, so this segment's just like a little bit thinner than the others, which might actually look better and look more consistent. I'm not entirely sure yet. We're gonna have to play that by ear, I think, but hopefully there we go, hopefully it turns out okay. Anyway, I'm going to start I need to replace this. I'm gonna start building up the rest of the portal here, because it goes up quite a few staircases. And I will be back with you guys when I finish like the outer kind of layer of it, so you guys can see what it looks like a little bit better. Okay, so this is a little bit more of the shape we're left with. We have exactly one chiseled quartz left over, so I got that pretty spot on. Now, how the rest of this is going to work is the portal. Let me just zoom out on my creative world here. Yeah, the portal is now going to have this layer of quartz here, which just goes like this, and it goes like across the whole thing. So it covers up the obsidian, it covers up the netherrack. It doesn't really matter what block the netherrack is. I just put netherrack there because we've got a lot of netherrack left over from digging out this whole thing. So I figured I might as well put it to some use and start using it on here. I'm gonna have to get up to the top of this actually. I need to do the exact same on the other side too. Can we do this? Can we pearl accurately? We can pearl accurately. There we go. So it ends up looking something a little bit like this, and it's gonna be the exact same on the other side. And then we need to get a layer of quartz. Let's just use the regular quartz for now, and we can do the layer of half slabs in a second. Is this gonna be enough quartz? Hopefully. This is very quartz heavy design, but that's fine. Because we actually ended up digging up most of the quartz that I've needed, just by digging out the nether itself. There is quite a lot of quartz, and with a Fortune 3 pick, you get your money's worth, your quartz is worth, I don't know. Anyway, so the design ends up looking a little bit like, if we just finish this off here. Oops, there's one little block there. There we go. Something like this, which is kind of the rough shape of a sundial. Now you can see it looks a little bit with that bit on the bottom. So I think what I'm going to end up doing is taking out this whole layer and replacing it with quartz. I think that might look a little bit better. And I think we might be short a little bit of quartz. Actually, I need to go mining for some. Oh, we have some more quartz. Oh, I didn't even realize we had a more quartz in inventory. Let's turn that into quartz. And then we have a little bit more. I don't think that'll be enough still. But we do have a little bit more. Now we've got 20 quartz slabs. I don't know if that'll be enough. But the original plan was to try and keep this kind of consistent with the quartz slabs that are kind of around the around the sundial here. So we can cover this whole top with quartz slabs. We're not gonna have enough. We could make some more, and then we could just go mine some more quartz. I don't think 12 will be enough. And then we can go mine some more quartz off camera, and then finish off the design and show you guys. Ooh, there we go. You replace yourself there. This I'm too short. Where are my pearls gone? There we go. Let's go up here. My voice sounds a little bit hoarse, by the way. I'm sorry about that. I haven't been sleeping very well. I've been very stressed about life in general, as, you know, as everyone is probably right now. But in a good way. In a good way. There's some good changes coming. So it ended up looking a little bit like Zeus. Which just makes the whole, like, outer, like, I guess, design of it just a little bit chunkier. And I think it just makes it look a little bit nicer, a little bit more, like, I feel really, like, a little bit more refined, but I just think it adds, like, a little bit more of a, you know, a definite shape to it. Whether this will stay as quartz, who knows? Personally, I think it's maybe a little bit too loud, and I'd actually quite like this quartz block to be replaced with another block. I might actually play around with it off camera. Originally, the design was going to be polished andesite, which I can take this quartz off and show you guys roughly what it would have looked like. which I kind of liked. I wasn't too sure on it, mainly because it looks very blocky. It looks very, you know, square. But it wasn't too bad a design, and I think just generally having a bit of a different color entirely kind of worked a bit better. I think it looked a lot nicer being a bit more of a stone design. I mean, maybe the best thing to do is to have both designs sitting here for now and then ask people, what do you guys think is the best? So maybe for you guys as well, and for people on TimeShot. So you guys can let me know which design you guys think is the better one. Let me accidentally dug a, hey, there we go. Can I reach? Yes, I can. Okay, let's just finish this design off by jumping like a mad woman. Oh no, what have I done? Come here. Yeah, I think having, not too dark, but the fact that we have dark glass, the fact that we have like black glass on the sundial design, I kind of wanted something to sort of match up to that. I didn't want it to be too dark. As I've been kind of saying from the start, and I've said this a lot of my streams especially, I've always wanted this nether hub design to be quite bright, at least in terms of most of the blocks being used on it, because Nether is a very dark place. Nether is a very dark and grim and mood lighting-y place to be, and I don't know if I really want the hub to be that dark. Now the glass is very dark, but of course it's going to look quite dark because of the all there is in there right now is netherrack and there's no lighting. In most of the biomes underneath there's going to be lighting and they're going to be a lot brighter. There's going to be grass and things like that, so I don't think it's too much of an issue right now having the black glass, because I think the actual design underneath is going to be a lot brighter. But that being said, the sundial is supposed to be like, you know, the place where the portal is, and I don't want it to look too dark. So this was an This was an alternative idea to have something like andesite. And I played around with a few other things like clay and stuff, but the clay never looked quite right. I think it needs to be a stone, which is why I liked having the andesite here. I just don't know if it looks too, you know, blocky, too ugly, because it's quite defined blocks. I tried it with stone as well, but stone didn't look very good. I wasn't very sure about that. Andesite is another possibility though, and maybe I'll keep it as andesite on this side and quartz on the other side, and you guys can let me know what you think, or if you think of another material which might look even better, then, oh no, I missed a block there too, then you can let me know of the material that you think looks better, maybe even include a screenshot or something like that, because you know, I don't build a ton. I'm not really a builder, which is why I really pushed myself to do this nether hub, because I thought, hey, it might be nice to, I thought it might be nice to just push myself a little bit and actually try something a little bit different than what I'd normally do. So I'm pretty happy with, where did I get a stack of quartz? Oh no, I got it from the other side. That means we can fill out this bottom bit at least. Which is why I've really pushed myself to try and, you know, do a lot of the design work for this nether hub, even though I'm getting help from people, and I'm hoping somebody will do the walls, because I don't think I'm going to be very good at doing walls. It is nice to be able to, actually try something new and get out of my comfort zone, because in Minecraft, my comfort zone is exploration and, I like coming up with ideas, but in terms of executing them, I'm not quite so good at. I like exploring and I like collecting and things like that, but I'm not so good at the whole designing aspect of things. Maybe something like that'll look good. I need to get out of here now. So I thought, hey, why not, you know, take myself out of my comfort zone a bit? It's not so far out of my comfort zone that I'm like, you know, I think I'm gonna be trash and not do well at it, but I think it's far enough that it's just nice to get myself to do something a little bit different and to push myself a bit more. So like that floor looks a lot better, actually. I quite like that. That looks okay. So if we do the same to the other side, but with the andesite, and then I can like let people make up their minds and see which one they think is better, now if they can see it in the flesh. Hopefully people like this design. The portal isn't quite in this, like, this is the thing I guess I was most worried about, the fact that the portal isn't quite in the center of the hub. It's not, you know, I'm hoping it'll still be the focal point, because it's quite difficult to miss. But the portal itself, like if you look at the previous hub from season one, the portal's like, actually the portal isn't in the middle of, is it? The hourglass is in the middle. The portal kind of, the spawn at least, comes out of the side of it. So maybe it won't be an issue. And it's still kind of in the middle. Like it's pretty close to the middle. It just means people who have portals on, you know, that side of the hub will just struggle a little bit more. But I'm hoping that it won't really be an issue. And I think people will like it. I hope people will like it anyway. It's quite difficult to miss. This big old, you know, portal just sitting here. Yeah, I think I like that a lot more. That just seems to flow a little bit better. And I do quite like the andesite. It just seems more like stone, more like it's made to go on a sundial, in my opinion, anyway. So I do quite like that design, but I think I'm going to leave it up to everyone else. But you guys let me know what you think. I tried to just integrate the portal into the design. I didn't want there to just be a portal sitting somewhere. I wanted it to be part of the design. The only way I could really think of doing it is having it as the middle bit in the sundial. And, you know, it's easy to jump through. It's easy to stand in. You don't have to jump over any blocks to get into it or climb up any stairs. It's just there. And then once you come through, you're here and you can choose, okay, which portal is mine? I'll go to that one. So hopefully people like it. And it keeps in with the theme of time. Right, now the next thing we're going to be doing is we're going to be doing the first segment. I haven't actually made up my mind which segment I really want the forest to be. It could be this one here. It could be the one right next to the portal. But because I might be altering the design a bit, I kind of want to keep these blank for now. So maybe I could do this one here or this one here. I don't know. It could be any of them. Let's just, you know what, let's close our eyes and let's spin our microcarrier around and then wherever we're facing, that'll be where we build. Here. Oh, dang it! I don't want it to be next to the... Here. There. Okay, right here. This is gonna be the, this one right here. Okay, pigmen, you're gonna have to die. Don't mind me. Sorry about that. anyway, I've got a whole chest full of materials here. Let's just dig down, actually. We probably want to go straight into here. Let's cover this up for now, because then we can kill these pigmen and maybe not have the others getting so angry at us, at least to start off with. I'm probably going to box myself in, because I'm kind of scared the pigmen are going to be super mad. I mean, they're obviously going to be super mad, but I don't want them to come at me too much. Now, the problem with this is... No, we're okay. Hey, buddy. Hey. Hey, there we go. Hey, hey, come here. Look, I just wanna, oh, see, that's my worry. No, you're supposed to, okay, you know what? Hello, don't. Don't, hey, look. Buddy, there's no use hiding. There you go. You're all right. It's okay. Good night, sweet prince. Okay. So there's going to be a lot of angry pigment. You know what? I should warn Tort. Tort, if you go in the nether, pigmen may be angry. Okay, I don't know if he's actually AFK or not. He AFKs quite a lot at his iron farm, I think. But I don't know if he's AFK now, but it'll be fine. Sorry, you'll be okay. Anyway, first thing we need to do is cover it in grass. I have no clue if I have enough grass and dirt. By the way, I might not. I also don't really know how dirt looks in the nether. It's probably going to look pretty gross. But we could try and hope it doesn't look too bad. We can fill up most of this anyway. I mean, there's dirt here. Why is there dirt here? Let's snag this dirt to give us a little bit of extra. There we go. To give us a little bit of extra coverage. Some of it's going to be sand as well, and some of it's going to be water. I'm just going to look at my design here now. Yeah, like most of it is grass, but there's a pool of water and there's a pool of lava. So let's just start placing grass. Grass looks so gross in the nether. Why does it have to look so gross? Now, of course, the main problem with doing different biomes is that biomes have different colored grass. And it's all going to look the same in the Nether. It's all going to look exactly the same, which is definitely going to be an issue, which we'll just have to, you know, tackle when we get to it. I can probably try and avoid a lot of the grassy biomes for the most part. You know, a lot of the biomes that have grass kind of have more iconic features to them anyway. So like flower forests have a lot of flowers in them, and you know, savanna have the savanna trees. So it'll probably be okay, I think. I'm definitely not gonna have enough grass for this. Whoopsie daisies. I need to work out exactly where these pools of water are going. I also don't know if grass spreads in the Nether. It's got to, right? If I put a torch down, the grass will spread, won't it? I hope so. Let's get a pool of something going. So we want a pool of water. Now, obviously, you can't put actual water down in the Nether. So to solve this problem, I have got lapis. I'll just use lapis as the water. We're going to want some sand. Oh, we don't have any sand. Okay, I'm gonna work on the outline for these pools. I've also got some lava buckets because we're gonna do a lava pool. I'm gonna work on the outlines for these pools, and then we're gonna work on getting some sand in place. So let's do the lava pool down here. I think we'll probably want it to be, I'm just looking at my design now. It kind of looks a little bit like a fish. It actually uses exactly 6 lava buckets, so it ends up looking a little bit like this. If I have it in the corner here, it has less of a risk of burning down trees, which is always nice, because nobody wants trees to be burned down. Let's just try and, if I dig this out here and put that here, I mean, here's the thing, none of these are gonna look exactly like the biomes. You know, it's gonna be too tough in a kind of miniature way to make it look like a proper biome, but we can do our dang best. I mean, people will look at these and hopefully think of the biome that they're supposed to represent, at least. I don't want the lava pool to be too, I just want it to be like that, and then we fill it with lava, and then that's just, you know, that's what it is. Let's remove this so we're not too close, and we can start filling it up with lava. Let's stack these up and move these here. Let's do that there. Let's do that one there. And then this one here. And then we got ourselves a dandy little... Can we gather these buckets? There we go. A dandy little lava pool. And then we can start filling this all up with grass. And there's going to be a water one a little bit further away from this. More kind of over here, I guess, kind of in the center of the trees. So we can work on this one. I'm gonna want dirt as the floor. See, grass spreads in the Nether, perfect. Okay, cool. I'm gonna want dirt as the floor though, so actually I'm gonna dig up this dirt rather than just re-dig grass. Oh my god, these pigmen are still so mad at me. Go away, pigmen, go away. I don't wanna know you, please. I'm sorry I killed your friend, but you know. Oh, no, I have no excuse for my actions, really. Let's dig these out. You know what? Why am I thinking we're gonna have to have dirt in the bottom? You can't see through it because we're gonna be using lapis. I'm an idiot. Okay, let's cover that back up and let's just build it with the lapis. There we go, put that there. All right, so my kind of lake has sort of 2 blocks here, and then it's got 4 blocks, and then it's got 3 blocks, and then it's got 1 block, and that's kind of the pool. It's not, you know, anything particularly fancy. It's got some sand around it too, but we can at least fill up this ground with a little bit more grass before we move on to the sand. I was thinking about doing a cave entrance as well, but it was kind of just too tricky to dig all the way down, and it was kind of difficult to make it look like a legitimate cave entrance. There we go, so we've run out of grass. All right, so we're gonna go and we're gonna get some more grass and we're gonna get some sand and we're, you know what, let's get away from these pigmen first. I wonder if I log out and log back in, will that fix their attitude towards me? Sweet, okay. That lava makes me really nervous though. I'm still kind of scared they're going to get mad at me. Let's get the glass out, ready to cover this up again. Seems okay. Where's the sand? I think it's over here. Don't mind me, pigmen. Don't mind me. Actually, why are we going all the way to the sand farm? All we need is a bit of grass and a bit of sand. We could just go to my base. I don't mind digging up a little bit of grass, a little bit of sand from my base. Let's just go back up here. So this is my tunnel right now. Eventually, once the hub is done, I'm going to be lowering my portal a lot. Because right now, it's a pretty long way up. But I don't think it'll make a difference if I just lower my portal, like the coordinates of it, down so it's in level with the hub. So I think it'll be fine. Do we have pearls? We do. Let's go get some sand and let's go get some grass from over here. Boop, there we go. I don't need a ton. I can just start taking some off the side of a hill, like, near me. Like, I don't really mind much. This whole top layer here doesn't need to be here. So I can just take that off. Oh no, there's stone there. Let's replace that stone with some of the grass that we just picked up. Because I don't really want any stone to be visible. There we go. And let's go get some sand while we're at it too. Okay, well, we'll probably need a stack of grass. We won't need a ton. We're gonna need more grass at some point. That's the only thing for some of the other biomes. Let's dig this whole thing down. It's like sticking out of the hill. Don't really like that. There we go. So I should probably go over the list of the full biomes that I'm gonna be showing on here, I guess. I'm actually trying to think of where that list is. It's saved on my computer somewhere. I think I might change up some of the biomes I'm gonna use as well, purely because I want to make sure that I'm not using too many grassy biomes and it looks, you know, really similar to the biomes that I'm going for. And some of the biomes might be a little bit tricky to do, just a tiny bit tricky. Let me have a look, actually. I've probably got it up on my computer here. Okay, so the full list of biomes that I'm going for, so we've got the, I guess this was originally going to be a flower forest, but now it's kind of just a regular forest. I mean, it could be filled with a lot of flowers, but the aim is for it to just be, a forest. There's going to be a mushroom biome, there's going to be a mesa biome, so neither of those use grass. Ocean biome, that doesn't use grass. There's going to be jungle, that uses grass, but a lot of it is going to be, you know, heavily covered in leaves anyway. The leaves are going to look a little bit dead. Just a little bit dead, but it'll be fine. A savanna biome. Again, that isn't used, like, the grass is pretty much looks like savanna grass anyway in the Nether, so hopefully that isn't a problem. A desert, that doesn't use grass. Ice spikes doesn't use grass. I guess it uses snowy grass, but I don't know if you can get snowy grass in the Nether. I know you can use packed snow, and that doesn't melt, and packed ice. But ice spikes hopefully will work out okay. Nether biome, I was thinking of just doing a little nether biome, like a little mini one, because we're in the Nether, so why not? A spruce forest biome and a cold tiger biome and an end biome. So those are the main biomes that I'm thinking of using, and they don't really use much in the way of grass. I don't think it's going to be too much of a disadvantage anyway. Like, we're not going to do what tree are they? Birch. We're not going to do, like, a birch forest. We're not going to be doing, you know, the forest or, like, the mossy cobblins. You know, like, maybe that's one we'll do for spruce instead of just doing a spruce biome. We could try and get a wolf in there or something. That's another thing. I want to get mobs into these eventually. I don't think we're going to be doing that today because that's going to be quite tricky. But I do eventually... Not chicken. I do eventually want to get mobs into each of these. I'm looking for pearls. So for this biome, I might have cows or maybe I'll have sheep. I'm not entirely sure yet. Chickens, I think, are going to go in the jungle because you see so many chickens in the jungle. And I think getting an ocelot into this, you can't really, like, can you put a lead on an ocelot that isn't tamed? I don't know if you can. I could try and get an ocelot in there. It's gonna be quite difficult though. If not, I'll probably just do chickens because you do see a lot of chickens in the jungle. But I'm gonna be trying to match up mobs into the biomes that they kind of correspond to. Some are gonna be trickier than others. I might do like a whole episode where I try to populate the Nether hub, because you can take animals through portals, can't you? I'm pretty sure you can. So that's gonna be the general aim. Whether I actually manage to do it or not is a whole different matter. Oh, get out of that block. It's a whole different matter, but hopefully I can. I gotta sort out my own portal at some point, because this is just redonkular. Oh, I'll tell you what I'll show you, and then I'll cut back to being in the Nether. We've gained a new neighbor. you can't really go over there and see. Actually, I think she's building right now, and I don't want to spoil her build if she hasn't shown it yet, so I won't go over there. But Pudsey has moved her base from being in the jungle to being not too far from our cliff over there, actually. There's, like, a lake, if you remember, that's to the left of that. I guess it's to the right from this angle. But when we're facing it from the other way, it's to the left. It's over that way. And she's building her base on a hill, mountain kind of place, just over there. So we got a new neighbor who's living super close to us, kind of in between where Code is and where I am. And we got a little present from her that says, from your new neighbor, Puds. Oh, it's Pavlova. Aww, it's a Pavlova. You know what? I'm hungry, so I'm going to put it out and have some now. Thank you, Pudsy. Let's put it here. Nom, nom, nom. Thank you. Oh, that's delicious. That's so delicious. Thank you, Pudsy. So we got our lovely new neighbor, Pudsy. I'm sure we'll be fast friends, I say, as though we aren't already friends. I'm sure we will be great neighbors to each other. You know, we already share so much in common. Like, you know, our love of note blocks and our love of pranking Edson and things like that. I'm sure we'll get on just swimmingly. Our love of villagers. So I think she's a good neighbor to gain. Maybe we'll send her a little welcome to the neighborhood present at some point too. I'm going to cut back when I'm back in the Nether and I've made a little bit more progress on the jungle biome. On the jungle biome? On the forest biome. Okay, so now that we've got the pond in place, I'm still not 100% sure about the lapis. You know, I feel like maybe, like, dyed sand? what am I saying? Dyed glass might actually be better. So what I'm imagining, if we instead put this lapis underneath, that's not what I want. If we put the lapis underneath right here, like that, and then if we die, then it might work better. If we die some glass, oh, we're just gonna have to like, there we go. I've got a little bit of sand left over. I'm not going to be using all of it. There'll definitely be enough here to dye. So if we throw a little bit of sand into here, I think 16 will be enough. There we go. And just let that smelt. And we, I don't know why I need a crafting table for this. And we make lapis into some lapis dye. And then we put the sand on top of the lapis. And I think that could look a lot better. There we go. A lot better. So let's, come on, smelt faster. Let's throw some of this stuff in the chest we don't need right now, actually. We got a lot of junk. We do not need most of this. Look at all this stuff. There's too much here. There's a chest. Where's that chest from? Do we have mob drops? We do have mob drops. Good. Come on, glass. You can do it. Almost there. There we go. That one's smelted. That one's smelted. That one's smelted. That one's smelted. So, I think this will look better, and I think it'll look a little bit more like water, I hope. I think it will. I don't see why it wouldn't look better. Oh man, that was almost straight in. There we go. So if we cover this like that, you see, I think that looks more like water, I think. I hope. Anyway, the next step is to build the trees. So we're gonna build some oak trees, which we need oak leaves for, and we're gonna build some birch trees, which we need birch leaves for. That'll be fine. Let me just zoom in on some of these trees on my other monitor so I know exactly how I'm building them. Some of them caught fire, unfortunately, in my test world, but that's fine. Trees sometimes catch fire. It was because of the lava, and I built them too close to the lava. Now the tricky thing is, this is actually lower than I had it for my design. I thought I had it three blocks. I had it four blocks high, but I think ghasts can spawn in that. They can, because it was four blocks high before I put the glass in place. And when I did that, sometimes ghasts spawned in them. So I'm pretty sure ghasts can spawn in that. So we're gonna have to make do with having a little bit of a smaller design. Hopefully it'll still look just as good. I mean, we're just gonna basically do tiny little, you know, like, look at this. Like, little trees like that. Like, look, it's a little babby tree. It's a little tiny babby tree. We can even do that to make this one, like, I don't know, a bit more padded out. Yeah, I mean, that looks fine. That's just a little babby tree. There ain't nothing wrong with that tree. So we can put, like, you know, a couple of them down. This one could be maybe a little bit scrawnier. We're just going to do a few of each tree. We don't want it to completely clog up the design in here. But we want it to look like a forest, after all. We're going to be putting some grass down. We're going to be putting down some flowers as well. So there we go. This is just, like, I love designing little things like this. Like, I've said this... I've said this on stream quite a lot, but I don't know if I've ever said it in a recording, that I'm a woman who really does well with detail. Okay, that shouldn't, emphasis on shouldn't, set fire to that tree. Hopefully it won't set fire to this one either. I'm a woman who's very good with, oh, I need more leaves, with detail. I tend to not do quite as well with big scale builds. I tend to do a lot better with small builds. And these mini biomes are all about the detail and all about getting the detail right. Really hoping that's not going to catch fire. It's quite close to the lava pool. Hopefully it's okay. Yeah, I love doing little designs for things. And this is exactly my forte. Just doing little tiny designs for things like this, you know, doing little trees here and there, you know, trying to work out the best place to put flowers. I love this kind of design work. So this is why for this hub, I'm kind of playing to my fortes. And even though the hub itself is huge, I am trying to have the design so it relies a lot on little things. It relies a lot on, you know, doing little designs to try and get the biomes right. So that's kind of my, there we go. That's kind of my aim with it anyway. I think that's enough trees, don't you? It doesn't need to be a ton of trees. We could put another one here if we feel like the forest is a bit sparse. Maybe we could scooch this one over a bit. Yeah, I'm gonna scooch this one over just a little bit. I don't have a silk touch axe, unfortunately. So I'm gonna have to make do with a, where do we want to put it here instead, maybe? This is a full tree, so let's do it like that. So I'm happy with the fact that this is really using my strengths. Here we go, let's take these leaves away. Because I think it'll turn out okay, because I'm playing to those strengths instead of, I guess just an oak one here. We have a lot of oak ones, but then these forests tend to have the majority be oak. So I'm hoping it'll turn out okay by doing it this way. There we go. That's quite a lot of trees. I think that's good. So the next step is to get this. Let's put these back. And let's take out all of our flowers and our grass and things like that. This is the bit I'm most nervous about, because this is when it all kind of went wrong and the whole forest kind of burnt down because of this lava pool here. I should have really thought about placing grass before. I'll tell you what, it's probably easier to bone meal. I wasn't actually sure if you could bone meal in the nether or not. Let's try. I didn't even pick that up. Oh my gosh. Good thing I realized. There we go. Let's see if we can bone meal. Because if we can, that would be a little bit handier. But yeah, the grass caught fire from pretty close. Aha, we can bone meal. Excellent. And that in turn spread to the trees. So we could do it like this, but then we're going to have to get rid of a lot of the grass that's near and just really hope nothing catches fire. We can keep an eye. We can keep an eye. But, Just mildly nervous that it's gonna burn the whole, you know, everything to the ground. I mean, it's fine, it's just wood that we can get more of. But I'd rather not have it burn to the ground. We're also gonna place these torches so they're under the trees, just so they're not quite as obvious. I don't really mind having the torches around, and I do want this to be lit. I don't mind the torches being, you know, visible. I just quite like it if they were at least a little bit hidden. Just so it's not, you know, it's a little bit more subtle that way. Let's put a torch over here under this tree too. There we go. I don't know if pigmen are light sensitive. If they spawn in certain lighting conditions or not. Actually, let's put this down and throw some of this stuff in we don't need. I don't think we need the bone meal anymore. Let's keep the flowers and stuff on us because we'll probably want to place some of those a little bit. Oh, we want some pumpkins as well. I got a couple pumpkins to fill it with. Let's place a few flowers that are a little bit different from the rest. There we go. Just make it look a little bit different. I guess it's a bit more flower foresty in that regard. There we go. This is cute. I'm liking how this is turning out. I think this will look okay. Let's put the daisy. Let's be risky and put it there. Let's put the lilac there. Oh, that's a big flower. Let's be risky, because why not? Can I place this flower over? I can. Yeah. Okay, lilac, if you catch fire, I'm going to be so sad. Please don't catch fire. There we go. Let's put a couple sunflowers down as well. Let's put one here. This is looking a bit bare. Let's put one over here. It's looking a bit bare. Let's put one here. Let's put one there. There we go. Okay. This doesn't seem to be catching fire. So hopefully it's okay. Should we be a bit risky and put a little bit of grass a little bit closer? I kind of feel like it's a little bit bare otherwise. We'll have to keep a sharp eye. That's what I'm worried about, those embers. Just catching onto something. There we go. Okay, let's put a bit of grass here as well. It's looking a bit bare. All right, and to finish off, let's put a couple pumpkins down. That's all right. Where should we put the pumpkins? They could go in like the middle here, maybe. In the center of the biome. Or maybe they should go over here, kind of where the water is. Let's remove a couple of these flowers. Let's put the pumpkins here. Let's put them like that. There we go. Okay, so I think this is done. Let's cover... Do I not have... Did I put my glass in here? I did. There we go. Let's cover this up and find an easier way out. Okay. This seems to be okay. This seems to be all right. Every time I hear it crackle, I'm like, but it seems to be okay. I think we're all right. Okay, let's have a look from the top down and see exactly how this has turned out. Let's cover this back up. Look at this. Look at this. We've got our little biome here. So we've got our little forest biome. I'm really pleased with how this has turned out. The torches aren't too obvious, but it's lit up. There's, you know, lots of colorful flowers and things like that here. It's got a couple pumpkins. It's got the trees. I think that's cute. I think that's turned out really nicely. It's not, you know, like a lush green forest like you'd expect from a regular forest. But I think it's turned out pretty cute. And that's just one of the biomes. So look, just this segment being lit up, like you can look around, it's really dark. And then that segment's lit up. And it just creates a really vibrant floor, I think. I think it just makes it look a lot nicer. Fingers crossed the lava doesn't spread. Fingers crossed it hasn't spread yet. I might hang around here a little bit after the recording just to make sure it doesn't spread. But that's it for this biome. Next time we do a biome, I think we're going to be building it with somebody. You're going to do a co-op-y kind of thing. The only other two biomes I've actually sort of planned out and tried to build are the end biome and the ice spikes biome. Now, the end biome I definitely want to build by myself because I got a really cute idea for it. But the other biomes, which I haven't even designed yet, I definitely want to be building with other people. So next time you see a segment being built, it'll definitely be built with somebody. Maybe we'll do the next one along and we'll just continue around the clock or something. But that is all from me. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you like this idea that I'm doing, and I hope the rest of it turns out okay. Much appreciate you guys watching, and I will see you in the next episode, where hopefully a lot more progress on this hub will be done. Goodbye!